taken advantage of the Tet truce in order to create maximum consternation in South Vietnam, particularly in the populated area.
John,
Mr. Ambassador,
good work. Thank you very much.
Well, I think General Wayne's going to take the credit, sir.
I'm aware of it.
I'll tell you this. Throw a hell of a party.
Yeah, real blowout.
Let's get a picture. Luke, get a picture. Come on.
I shall not seek, and I will not accept, the nomination of my party for another term as your president.
I, Richard Milhouse Nixon, do solemnly swear that I will faithfully execute the office of President of the United States.
North Vietnam cannot defeat or humiliate the United States. Only Americans can do that.
You get really stoned. Then, you know, like, who cares about the war?
Gentlemen.
And ladies. As you know, General Westmoreland has returned to Washington, and General Abrams has replaced him as commander of ground forces. This reorganization is part of the president's Vietnamization strategy. Now, the new second-in-command, General Nguyen, is here to brief you on the implementation of this phase of the war. General?
Excuse me, Ambassador. With Abrams in and Westy out, is this an official admission that Westmoreland's strategy was a failure?
General Westmoreland was promoted.
General,
ladies and gentlemen, we now believe that the South Vietnamese are ready to take on a primary role in driving back the enemy's forces, their divisions, North Vietnamese regulars across the
General,
western border.
Is this an American withdrawal?
No, no, in no way could this be interpreted as a withdrawal.
It's a change of strategy. And I have appointed the former Lieutenant Colonel John Van, whom you all know.
General!
John,
General!
John, General!
General.
Out there,
sir!
To act as my deputy for military functions, who will help me implement this strategy. He will serve as a commanding general for the Central Highlands region.
General, please, General, General, let me clarify this. You're placing a U.S. civilian in command of 10 divisions of South Vietnamese troops in the Central Highlands, which is a fairly sizable area, while the rest of the U.S. troops pull back?
We're not pulling back. The South Vietnamese are moving forward.
If it's not a withdrawal, what does Vietnamization mean?
Well, that's what we're trying to explain to you, if you just pay attention.
Oh, John, in all fairness, you've always been an advocate that the U.S. take control here in Saigon, yes?
That's correct. Tet has proved that the South Vietnamese are capable and willing to take control of this
General,
war.
General,
the American people have been completely demoralized by recent developments.
Not at all. Not at all. On the contrary, our intelligence, in fact, indicates that it is the Viet Cong who have been demoralized since Tet.
Wait, I'm highly confused, and I find this contradictory, because, in fact, with this restructuring, the South Vietnamese are not in command, but you are, Mr. Van, while the U.S. forces go out the back door.
No one is going out the back door.
Sir, what are you saying?
Will any American soldiers be going home?
Certainly, as the Vietnamese people assume greater responsibility for the war effort, there will be some reassignment of U.S. support personnel.
General, John, did you meet with President Nixon and discuss Vietnamization?
I met the president, yes.
So was it his policy or your policy?
It's the policy of the United States government.
U.S. policy has not changed from day one in terms of our involvement in helping the people of the Republic of Vietnam.
Nixon ordered all American combat troops out of Vietnam by June of 1972. The South Vietnamese, although backed by American air support and advisors, would have to fight the war themselves. 10 years down the road, we were back to where we started. But this time, John Paul Van was in charge.
Intelligence says that the enemies moved large numbers of troops, maybe 5 divisions, down the Ho Chi Minh Trail to here. We also know that there's heavy artillery, even tanks, further north.
I see what they're after. They can break through the line here and head for the sea. They'll have cut our forces in half and have a clear shot at Saigon.
The South Vietnamese troops can't hold the line. It's over.
South Vietnamese are good soldiers. They just need some goddamn leadership. Oh, they'll hold the line. We'll do one better. We might turn this whole goddamn thing around. I I think old General Jaff's about to make the mistake we've been making all along. He's going to try to fight this thing in a conventional fashion. If we can persuade him to send his troops out of these hills around Khantoum, he'll be vulnerable. And that's where we could crush him.
I don't know, John.
I do, Fred. I do. I've never seen anything so clear. I've been waiting for a moment like this all my life.
Yeah, what can I do for you?
I'd like to have a word with Van, please.
Close. General.
It's okay, let him through.
I'd like an interview, John.
I don't have time.
Okay, I'll make it quick. Do you intend to carpet bomb around Khantoum with B-52s?
That's operational information.
What a line of bullshit you fed us about the peasants and the revolution, and I bought it.
I still believe it.
But you're gonna bomb with B-52s? How can you say that? It's wrong, John, it's wrong.
It's wrong? Same goddamn war it was back in 62. You were there. Why didn't you say it was wrong then? Shit. You and the fucking Kennedys, the good old boys who sent us here. Now y'all want to change your minds because there's blood and guts on TV. Well, I don't have that luxury. I've got 50,000 people in Khantoum whose lives are on the line because of us. They can't change their minds, can they? I gave those people my word, and I'm going to do everything I can to save them. Let's go. Colonel Bob.
Welcome, sir.
Frank Drummond, I thought they retired you.
Well, retirement seems to be sitting pretty good with you, John. Thanks for requesting me, buddy.
My pleasure.
Major Darryl Jones, sir.
Major Jones, finally, I got a fighting team I can be proud of. Well, gentlemen, let's get to work.
This way.
Gentlemen, senior advisor.
At ease, man. All right, listen up, everyone. We are going to hold the line here at Tan Can, then mount a stage retreat back to where we are, Khantoum. That will pull these North Vietnamese divisions out of the hills, and when they do, we are going to call in the B-52s and carpet bomb each of these squares. We are going to wipe out the 2nd, 3rd, and 5th Division of the North Vietnamese Army. My old colleague, Colonel Ba, will conduct the forward command defense and withdrawal. This is General Jap, commander of the NVA. He's a genius. He's never been beaten. Till now. I've studied this man for 10 years, and we're gonna whip his ass. You know why? Because he wastes his men, pours them away like piss in the wind. There's not a man in this room, not a man on that line out there I wouldn't die for. No matter what we've done with our lives, you and I can be proud today because we have the noblest of all professions. We are soldiers. Good Lord said it all about us. He said, no greater love has a man than he lay down his life for another. And by God, this day will not end, but I will see you all safely through it, and we will hold this ground.
Sustained mortar and small arms fire. Over.
Get me a sit rep forward command.
Khantoum forward, Khantoum command. Sit rep. Over.
Enemy still 500 yards to my immediate front. We're holding them here.
Roger that, Major. Good work.
Tell Colonel Vaughn we will withdraw in 1 hour. Over.
Tommy?
Oh, what the hell are you doing here? Why aren't you at your post?
I have been replaced, sir.
Who the hell's in charge of the orbit?
Who's the general?
Are you there now?
It's General Den, sir.
Tell him I'm on my way.
Sir, Contook 4, the 6 Archer was en route to your fix. Out.
Contook said fans on the way out.
Let's go! Four command! Step on it!
Okay, we got an enemy tank here. We have an enemy tank.
There's a tank! Over. There's a fucking tank!
We got an enemy tank to our rear.
There are no enemy tanks reported in this sector.
Fuck you, son! I'll tell you there's a goddamn tank up here.
How long to the LZ?
We're 2 minutes out.
Well, let's go! Get a move on! Let me cut off up there, goddammit!
Ordered to withdraw.
Withdraw nothing. Get Bomber Command on the horn.
Sir, the enemy have already passed the coordinates.
Give them these new coordinates.
Stand by.
1586. 1580.
Sir, that's us.
Call it in.
1586. 1580.
Soldier, let me have a look.
That's correct. Yes, we know. Sir, they want confirmation.
We don't have time for this horse shit. We're about to be overrun. Just do it!
Senior advisor says go.
Recon
Recon Skyhawk. Enemy now 800 yards. Over.
Major, here they come.
Colonel, let's get ready.
You wave okay?
Get out there, see what's left.
Here he is now.
Roger, at command. Touchdown, Tonto, at command. Over.
What is all this?
Congratulations, John. That was a hell of an action.
Mr. Ambassador?
John, the President asked me to come and convey his and our country's appreciation.
Thank you, sir.
John, step right this way. We've had a little surprise here for you. John, President Chu.
Mr. President.
The people of Vietnam are grateful for your help in defending our country.
I'm honored. Thank you.
Come on.
Congratulations, John. You deserve it.
This was great, Fred, but I better be getting back.
Sure.
Yeah. Duty calls.
Good luck, John.
You know, Fred, we can win this thing.
You bet.
Come on, I'm not here to supply gossip for you.
Yes, but excuse me one moment.
John! Congratulations.
Thank you.
I have something that might interest you.
Former Vietnam veteran Douglas Elders claimed the U.S. government has conspired to deceive the American people in order to pursue an illegal war in Vietnam. Well, I'll be damned.
Well, at least someone's prepared to stop peddling the lie.
Well, now, what lie would that be?
That we're here to solve Vietnam's problems. We're the problem, and that's the truth.
You see, Stephen, there's your truth, and there's my truth. And they're two different things. All I know is up that road's old General Jap. When he and I speak to each other, we never lie.
General Jap and you? John, the war's not about warriors anymore. It's about children and women and rice paddies. You know who told me that? You did. You did.
Thank you. I gotta go. I got men holding the line up there.
Boss, we really don't have the weather.
Come on. Let's go.
He's dead? How? I was just... Oh, man. John Paul Vann was America's warrior. He personified our good intentions, our arrogance, our courage, and ultimately our folly. He had fought to redeem the unredeemable, to salvage the doomed enterprise called South Vietnam. In death, he had triumphed over defeat, while the rest of us are left to ask, why?
Where have all the flowers gone? Young girls pick them, everyone. When will they ever learn? When will they ever learn? Where have all the young girls gone? Long time passing. Where have all the young girls gone? Long time ago. Where have all the young girls gone? Gone to young men, everyone. When will they ever learn? When will they ever learn? Where have all the young men gone? Long time. Where have all the young men gone? Long time ago. Where have all the young men gone? Gone for soldiers, everyone. When will they ever learn? When will they ever learn? Time passing. Where have all the soldiers gone? A long, long time ago. Where have all the soldiers gone? Gone to graveyards, everyone. When will they ever learn? When will they? Time passing. Where have all the graveyards gone? Long time ago. Where have all the graveyards gone? Gone to flowers, everyone. When will they ever learn? When will they?
When the truth is found to be lies, and all the joy within you dies, don't you want somebody to love? Don't you need somebody to love? Wouldn't you love somebody to love? You better find somebody to
We are in Thailand making this Vietnam War story.
Neil Sheehan wrote an incredible book, Bright Shining Light, won a Pulitzer Prize, and we're making a two-hour movie.
I play John Paul Van, who had worked his way up through the ranks.
What an incredible life he lived in this 10 years of his life from 62 and 72 in Vietnam.
It's a complicated process, very complicated. The climate, subject matter, huge number of elements, different eras, pulling together a crew from around the world.
Terry George is directing this.
Terry's an amazing screenwriter and director.
He's a real actor's director.
You guys are pushing the empire, right?
John Paul Van had an amazing life and the people's lives he touched.
He's not your average human being. I mean, he lived like 15 lives in one.
He saw it all. He saw it from the beginning to almost the end.
He was a hero, he was a heroic character who saved people's lives, and at the same time he was ruthless, he was arrogant.
I hold the secret weapon to win the war in South Asia.
The moral code he upheld in war was something phenomenal. The moral code he upheld with his wife and his family was kind of something different.
Tell me about your wife.
He was just one of these guys who would just see something and he would just say what he thought. He broke the chain of command on several occasions. He was kind of a loose cannon.
What's the meaning of this?
Sir, we've been ordered to withdraw.
Withdraw nothing. Get Bomber Command on the horn.
He thought the higher-ups would never let him become a general.
He was elevated to a status that is unprecedented in American military history. He was elevated to civilian two-star general.
Finally, I got a fighting team I can be proud of.
He is the perfect metaphor between being a hero and having so many secrets. He was a bright, shining light.
What we had to do is create a napalm aftermath with lots of fire, black smoke and stuff. We're very aware there will be Vietnam vets watching this movie, so we're trying to get it as right as we possibly can.
Vietnam is so phenomenal for so many different reasons. It kind of was the end of the American age of innocence.
There were lies taught to the American public and to the world that are remembered by everyone and that scarred the political and social face of the United States during the 60s and early 70s.
America's involvement in it, the Vietnamese government itself was a lie, the way the war was fought was a lie, the whole war was a lie.
Vietnam was the first war that the correspondents really had political pull in. Correspondents were being given no information whatsoever, and that's why in this war they started going out into the field and hanging out with the fighting man, and they realized that it was a lie. Their way of getting back was through the pen, and that's what they did.
That's Van, I can just hear him say it. I want him busted now.
It's a very political movie, and it's going to affect a lot of different people in different ways.
You see things through a very personal, direct, and a simple.